Welcome back to the channel. I hope everyone are doing good. So in today's video, we'll be seeing about the second part of the explanation of light. In the previous video, we saw about what is light, source of light, types of objects and what is shadows. If you have missed my video, I'll be pasting the link in the cards and also in the description. Go visit that too. In today's video, the topics to be covered are types of surfaces, reflection and loss of reflection. So let's get started. A surface is simply a ground or plane in which light strikes and reflects back. There are two types of surface. The first one is rough and the second one is smooth. A rough surface has a lot of irregularities and lumps in it, as shown in the picture here. Some common examples of rough surface are newspapers and alligator skin. Whereas a smooth surface doesn't have any lumps or irregularities in it, as shown in the picture here. For example, ice cubes and plane mirror. It's not that it doesn't have any irregularities in it, but in comparison with the rough surface, it has little bit of irregularities. Now, let's move into reflection. The bouncing back of light is called as reflection. Based on the surface the light strikes, the reflection can be classified into two types, regular and irregular reflections. If a ray of light strikes a rough surface and gets reflected back, it is said to be an irregular reflection, as shown in the picture here. And the lines are not parallel in an irregular reflection. Whereas, when a ray of light strikes a smooth surface and gets reflected back, it is called as an regular reflection, as shown in the picture here. And the lines are parallel to each other. Let's move deeper. Based on the striking and reflecting of light, scientists have derived two laws called as the laws of reflection. Before going into the laws of reflection, you should be knowing some terminologies related to the laws of reflection.
In order to understand the laws of reflection more deeper, I have made a setup here. So the first thing to be explained is the ground or a plane where the setup is placed. So the next thing is the incident ray. Incident ray strikes the plane mirror at a point. So in this diagram, AN is the incident ray. And the next one to be explained is reflected ray. The reflected ray is the bouncing of the light from the surface or the ground. So in this diagram, NB is the reflected ray. The point where the incident ray hits the ground or the plane is called as the point of incidence. In this diagram, point N is the point of incidence. The perpendicular line drawn from the point of incidence is called as the normal. In this diagram, line ON is the normal. The angle between the incident ray and the normal is called as the angle of incidence. We can mark it as an angle I. And the angle between the normal and the reflected ray is called as the angle of reflection. We can mark it as angle R.
Now that you have understood the terminologies related to the laws of reflection, I am going to say the laws now.
The first law states that the incident ray, the reflected ray and the normal at the point of incidence lie on the same plane.
The second law states that the angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Let's measure that with the protractor. If I measure the angle ANO, I would be getting 44 degrees. And when I measure ONB, I got 44 degrees the same. I hope you like this video. So make sure to like and share this video and subscribe to my channel, Shanghai's Experiments.